No, it's very easy. You just go on the website of the state of Geneva. Basically, my role.
He's my hero. Dan kita serius dan bersabar. Insya Allah, suatu saat pasti Anda akan menemukan jalan.
Hey guys, I'm Didi Rajavani. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing great today. So in this final part, Vema and her husband are going to share their experience with us so we can learn something from them. Okay? But if you haven't watched the first and the second part, I strongly recommend you watch them first. Links are available in the below descriptions. First of all, I'm going to ask Vema about the roles of her husband in making this home-based business more sustainable. And then ask her to share some tips with us on how to start a home-based business and so forth. Afterwards, I'm going to invite her husband to share his insight, his experience in dealing with some challenges and in boosting the business of his wife. Can't wait to see our discussions? If so, let's get started. But if you don't mind, can you please click subscribe this channel and press the bell icon too. Thanks for your support. So, kalau tidak keberatan, maukah Mbak Vema share dengan kami tentang peran suami dalam mengembangkan usaha catering ini? Silakan, Mbak.
Ya, dia support aku dan dia sangat membantu dalam bisnis atau mungkin dalam hal-hal lain ya. Karena untuk semua ini saya nggak bisa melakukan sendiri. Apalagi yang memang kalau itu namanya catering itu nggak mungkin dengan satu tas. Jadi dia support kalau lagi banyak orderan atau lagi banyak event besar seperti itu, dia di belakang saya. Dan juga untuk hal-hal yang menyangkut administrasi, pastinya saya akan lari ke dia, saya nggak bisa sendiri.
Seperti apa itu, Mbak? Administrasi, boleh dikasih contoh atau gambaran?
Itu ya mungkin kalau harus, mungkin untuk register ya. Kalau ke sana saya nggak bisa sendiri karena saya minim Prancis.
Bahasa Prancisnya masih minim ya, tapi masih udah banyak mengerti.
Lagi belajar.
Hampir sekali ini Mbak Vema.
Ya itu emang saya serahkan ke suami saya karena dia yang selalu membantu saya dan support banget saya. He's my hero.
Oh wow, terima kasih Mbak.
Wow, Mbak Vema bilang that her husband is a hero. Well, sebelum saya mengundang suami Mbak Vema, saya akan meminta Mbak Vema untuk berbagi tips dengan teman-teman agar termotivasi, terinspirasi untuk membuka sebuah usaha. Oke, silakan Mbak Vema.
Sebenarnya sih melakukan hal kecil itu bisa dari mana aja ya. Karena sesuatu yang kecil itu nanti suatu saat akan membesar asal kita telaten menekuni. Oke, semua sih kembali ke passion kita ya. Kalau kita ingin melakukan sesuatu karena dari dalam diri kita, pasti kita tidak akan merasa bosan. Dan mungkin Anda juga ya, kalau punya suatu hal kecil lah, mungkin itu kerajinan tangan atau sesuatu yang mungkin hobi dan digeluti dan diseriusi, mungkin alam itu suatu saat akan menjadikan suatu pekerjaan. Dan kalau sudah menjadikan itu pekerjaan, jadi pastinya kita dapat income. Nah itu yang harus kita pegang, jangan kita memaksakan sesuatu yang di luar kita tidak bisa. Kita jadikan untuk bisa, kayaknya tuh kita merasa tertekan ya. Jadi mendingan apa yang kita bisa ya di depan mata kita lakukan. Dan kita serius dan bersabar, insya Allah suatu saat pasti Anda akan menemukan jalan.
Nah, seperti yang kalian lihat sendiri bahwa melakukan suatu kegiatan usaha itu diawali dari hal yang terkecil. Memiliki inisiatif, memiliki daya kreasi, melakukan inovasi, dan jangan cepat bosan. Kemudian, nikmati apa yang kalian kerjakan, juga mengoptimalisasikan apa yang kalian miliki untuk dijadikan sesuatu produk yang punya nilai tambah. Oke, sekarang saya akan undang suami Mbak Vema untuk berbagi pengalaman bagaimana beliau ini membantu usaha yang ditangani oleh Mbak Vema. Oke?
Can I call just Mas Benoit?
Yes, that's fine. Yes, Mas Benoit. Okay.
Mas Benoit, why? Yes. To give her like Java, a bit Javanese style.
Yeah, okay, good.
Okay, Mas Benoit, can you please maybe tell us a bit of your role in making your wife's business successful?
Basically, my role was to... Because before, I was an accountant.
Interesting.
A long time ago. During 13 years, I was doing accounts and tax declaration for the clients in a company. So I know a little bit how to organize the administration. So basically, at the beginning, I was doing all the paperwork.
Yeah.
And also, because she couldn't drive, I was doing the delivery. I was doing the delivery to the clients.
Yeah.
So I was bringing the food, the lunchbox to the WHO, WTO, or ILO. So I was doing, and I'm still doing, the delivery man. You know, like this. That's it's my role. Also, sometimes at the beginning when she didn't have a lot of finance, the business was beginning.
Yeah.
We had to invest for the cooking, for the food, or
for the
stocks,
equipment.
For the equipment. So I helped a little bit.
Nice.
So that's my role.
And in regard to this administrative stuff, administrative work, as Vilma was telling me that for like registrations, I have to ask my husband because, her friends is a bit limited.
Yes.
But I think she's just too humble.
Not
she's just too humble. So do you mean that your business is officially registered?
Yes, it is.
Is it very difficult to register?
No, it's very easy. You just go on the website of the state of Geneva, www.ge.ch, and you find the registre du commerce. And then everything is explained online, and you just follow the step by step, and it's very easy. You just have to pay. I can't remember exactly how much, but a very little amount of money, and then you are registered. It's very easy. It's very easy. It takes what takes time is to go there. Is to go at the officials in the city center. That takes time and to wait.
You have to queue,
A little bit. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. But it's not difficult, no.
So Mas Benoit, can you tell me whether or not you like your roles?
I like my role because it makes my wife successful. That's why I like my role. Because now I have a company.
Yes.
And it takes me a lot of time to run this company, and it's a huge work. So it's not easy as it was like before. But I always found, because it's my company, so I can leave my colleagues and go to help my wife. And they all know my wife, and they all know her business. So they understand when I say, sorry, I have to go to make delivery, the food for them, they all understand and I can go.
So all the logistic stuff also you do that for this business. The logistic like shopping, helping
for them up.
Yeah, for her. Her
yes, for my wife. Yes, yes. I go.
It's a lot of
yes.
work, you know. You have your own professions and you help her. You know, you have also Fabian, your
yes.
lovely son. How do you deal or how do you divide your time?
There is no, because if you would say okay, I have this and that, you will never be able to do it. Yes, you have to handle it how life brings the things, you know.
So
we manage. Okay, for example, she said to me, I have customers, they want some delivery for this day. Can you do it, or can you can manage or not? I say yes, it's okay, I'm fine, I have time and I can handle it.
If I cannot, if I have appointment in Lausanne or for the business, I say sorry, I cannot do it. So try to find another day. So that's why, that's how we organize all the things, you know.
Vima, concerning the orders from your regular or your new clients, do you regulate them to place their order in some days earlier?
Yeah, but it's really impossible. I can manage. I can refuse.
Oh, okay.
If they really cannot doing another day, so.
So
I refuse.
Because
it's impossible. Instead, I make problem for myself.
Alright,
so for him.
Okay, so they have to order in certain days in advance.
Yeah.
Before.
Yes, of course. Okay. Maximum can be like 1 week before the order. So if it was, for example, suddenly, once somebody asking for 70 boxes in one day, that's impossible. So I cannot.
Alright, so. You don't want to disappoint yourself and also your husband, your clients as well.
Yeah.
So it's a maximum or minimum a day, 1 week or maximum, no, the minimum 1 week order.
Or minimum like 4 days.
4 days minimum.
If it's a big quantity. If small quantity, I can manage by myself. So I didn't ask him.
Ah, right.
I did.
So, yeah. Is there any roles that you don't like, Mr. Penel?
No.
what I
don't like is the last minute.
Ah.
The last minute things I don't like.
Right.
And also what I don't like is sometimes, because it's one of the character of Indonesian. She said to me, okay Benoit, you have to go to the Ovib to deliver the food. I said, but come on, Ovib is a big area. What's the address? And sometimes it's sometimes when she doesn't tell me, okay, you have to go at Rue des Contamines or Rue. No, you have to go to Rue des Oliviers. Come on,
that's
speak.
Many numbers.
So many numbers.
Yes.
So it's sometimes there is nothing really, something I hate.
Alright.
No, I cannot say there is something I hate. Yeah. But sometimes it's a little bit annoying that when you have a lot of things to think. And then she said, oh, you have to go there. Yes, but come on. Where is it exactly? That's all.
Ah.
The rest there is no. Because I'm happy that she's successful, and because she's successful, I am successful as well.
Right. Yes. When she's happy, you are happy as well.
Yes, yeah. Of course.
That's Christmas. That's Christmas, Fema. Yeah.
Also in traffic.
yes, yeah. the traffic,
yes.
It's something
it's
really...
It's trouble for us, yeah.
You get nervous.
I'm getting nervous, yes, yeah. Yes.
Yes, I can understand. Geneva is a really big city,
yeah.
But also
it's not a big city, it's a disaster for the traffic.
Yes,
yeah.
It makes me nervous.
Yeah.
It makes me nervous.
But I mean, big in terms of like, as compared to maybe Basel, for example. Basel is smaller, that's why
I understand.
Geneva is big and also many traffic jam,
yes.
As compared to Basel, because I used to live in Basel before.
Yeah, you know, here a lot of traffic jam.
Thank you, Mas Benoit and Mbak Fema.
You're welcome, thank you very much.
Very interesting interview, very interesting perspective for your businesses and insight of giving motivation to others, yes. So, again, thanks a lot and see you again next time, maybe.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
See you.
Bye.
So guys, kalian tahu sendiri bahwa rules-nya Mas Benoit ini tidak sebatas urusan administrasi dengan pemerintah setempat seperti mengurus izin usaha catering ini. Tapi Mas Benoit ini juga menjadi pengirim makanan yang dipesan oleh para pelanggan karena Mbak Fema masih belum berani atau belum berani menyetir mobil sendirian, ya. Dan hal lain yang dapat dijadikan pembelajaran bersama di sini adalah komunikasi, ya. Komunikasi dari awal ini memang penting dan sangat perlu sehingga akan memudahkan urusan dalam usaha catering ini dan pastinya urusan-urusan lainnya. Kalian tahu bahwa hampir semua aktivitas di Swiss itu dilakukan secara sistematis, direncanakan, diagendakan secara teratur seperti antrian dalam sebuah produksi FIFO, first in first out. Saya sendiri merasakan bagaimana suatu aktivitas itu harus terencana, harus tersusun jauh lebih awal sebelum aktivitas itu sendiri terlaksana. Diakui atau tidak,
karakter atau lebih tepatnya budaya kerja di Indonesia itu juga ada perencanaannya. Hanya saja, seringkali atau kebanyakan rencananya itu dadakan atau spontanitas. Tapi semoga di masa ini rencana atau kerja seperti dadakan ini tidak lagi terjadi di Indonesia. Well, thanks a lot for watching this final part. I hope you guys like it. You are inspired and motivated to start a business. If so, I leave it up to you to click like, to click subscribe and press the bell icon too. Should you have any questions, comments, feedback, please write them down below in the comment sections. I'm Didi Lejavani. Once again, thanks a lot for watching this video and see you soon. Ciao.